Fine. So you all know me as someone who has been working in this area for close to 15 years, both as a professional as well as someone who is interested in taking the dialogue of UX forward and then make sure that we are all discussing the right things and relevant things as a community, right? So I have a confession here to make. So for all the good intentions that we all have as designers, particularly me in this case, with all the good intentions and stuff, so the thing is, I feel guilty about the fact that there have been some loopholes in preparations, be it on the project side or be it on the activities that have led to this conference, in terms of making this conference the best conference ever possible. But then, as always, there are gaps and there are misses that you would make because of certain lapses in concentration and certain distractions, usual standard distractions that happen because of your daily routines and stuff like that, right? So all these things add up and they lead to an outcome which probably is not the right intended outcome as you would want it to be. But it is it might be a good final output, but then it still is a compromised output for somebody like us, like me included, like all of us, right? So we are all passionate designers who would want to achieve something which is pixel perfect in every sense. Pixel perfect means pixel perfect in every sense, as in not just in the UI, but also in terms of the overall experience that you want to offer to your customers. Like in the context of this conference, we wanted it to be a dream conference, but then obviously there'll be some gaps here and there and all the stuff. So what it all boils down to, something that is deep rooted within us. So this presentation is, it's all about that, right? So we all do this day in and day out. We keep customers at the center of everything that we do. And we think, in order to do so, we think everything about the customer, what is happening to the customer in terms of his journey, in terms of his experiences, the feelings he goes through. What are the elements that influence his experience, the elements that influence his journey in any given context, right? So in this case, as you're seeing, I think in any journey map that we do, we always think about what has this customer been through before, what is he going through while using the product that you have designed, and what experience he would go through after it has been designed, right? And what are some of those factors that would influence from the outside of it, right? So be it outside or inside, but along with the journey, there are certain standard factors, be it the people that he comes in touch through the journey, be it the spaces that he goes through, be it the devices and touch points and all that stuff. So a standard customer journey elements, right? So this is one of the customer journeys that we have done. It's just taken as an example for the sake of reference to talk about all the aspects that we as designers focus on. But the most important thing here is that the curve at the bottom, which is the happiness index. So our entire focus as designers is we want that curve to be as high as possible at no given point, right? But obviously there will be some gaps here and there because of dependencies, and it's not a linear thing. It's a much complex thing wherein it's got lots of factors going in and out along the journey. So we take every care in making sure that all those elements play well to ensure that journey is smooth enough for the customers and they are always in happy state, right? So speaking about influences to the journey, so if I were to take that linear journey and then circle it around for the sake of helping this presentation understand easily for you, you're going to see this kind of representation also the presentation wherein the customer is at the center and that orange thing around it is the happiness index. And the factors that are kind of floating around are the external influencing factors wherein we all are very familiar with those factors, right? One is designer, product managers, and all those guys who play different roles in their own capacity to help the customer get the best possible experience and keep the happiness index high. But what happens then, right? So we would like to think of as the main first-class citizen who take pride in taking the responsibility of keeping the customers happy all the time, right? So we would like to lead that that entire ecosystem of keeping that customers happy by creating something, by doing the right things, and by making sure that we elevate the happiness index, right? And which could potentially result in something like this. So in this case, this particular example was in the context of an IT administrator, wherein if we do all the right things and then if we make sure that his happiness index is high, that increases his credibility and growth, because he is also employed somewhere, and then he all the things that we do is to elevate him, right? So it elevates his growth, it improves his work-life balance, and then it also increases his happiness index. And at the same time, I think, because he's on a holiday in this example, he has to probably still deal with some annoying phone calls, because he being an IT administrator, sometimes on and off, even though he's on holiday, he has to put up with those things. But all in all, I think as long as we make sure that he's happy and then he gets to his work-life balance and then he gets enough credibility and growth, I think that's the state we want our customers to be. So all the design work that we do, if we see this kind of thing as designers, I think is something that we take pride of as far as our work is concerned. What beyond that, right? So once he's happy, then there is this small connected worlds with him. So those are the same worlds that we have seen, right? Customers, that he's still at the center, but there are, we ourselves are customers to somebody else, right? So be it a designer or PM or dev or all the roles that have, that could influence this customer would in turn get influenced by our own external influences. So in this case, if you take the example of designer, which is us, we have our own world wherein we have got a lot of influences going around us, right? So it's like a world within a world. If we are thinking about customers, somebody else is thinking of us as their customers. And we have our own sphere of influences around us, which actually influence the state that we go through day in and day out, which would in turn influence the customer. So it's really important for us to be mindful and be aware of the fact that what kind of external influences that we go through. I mean, we all know what kind of things are riding on us every day in and day out, but then we may not be able to focus on them that closely. And hence, that's the reason why we are discussing about the impact over here in this conference, wherein if we can take some time out and then see that if we can address at least one of those factors, you know, be it in extra time or as a community, so that will help us elevate and alleviate some of these problems, which will in turn help us focus on customer problems, right? So in this case, let's focus on something, right? So here, again, trying to map our own journeys is probably one of the ways to look at it, our own journeys and all the external influential factors. But the thing that is in focus here is the stress levels. So the blue graph over here is the levels of stress that we go through every day in and day out, and then what kind of influence it will have on the goals that we all have. The common goals is to take care of customers' happiness index, right? So so just to map these activities on a simple spectrum from left to right, of all the activities that are there on the left side, those are the most common frequent activities that we go through every day, which adds to our stress levels, which some of them go ignored, some of them get noticed, but then we don't get enough time, enough luxury to address those things. And we don't want to end up in a situation where we have to hire a designer to solve our problems, right? So it should be our responsibility to at least take some time out and then see that if we can address those things on the left side, like those standard things. And also all the way at the down is unwarranted information that we are already overloaded with so much of information. And then if we can somehow, in some way, if we can take a closer look at the things, simple things like emails and alerts and all those things, which we actually don't need in certain contexts. Like if I'm driving, I don't want to be bothered with unnecessary things, unnecessary emails, which might have an adverse impact on my mental state and stuff which might affect my entire day. If my day is affected, I lose one crucial day out of my 2 weeks of sprint time, and then I had to compromise on the product quality, right? So last month I was working on a project wherein I was trying to get some simple documentation done, which was a simple piece of text, a landing page screen text, which is very important for the first time experience of our customers, right? But that ticket is still open. I feel guilty about it. So, and that happened just because of this kind of influences on my life, right? So, and on the right side are some rare occurrences like annoyances and incidents and accidents, which puts the focus on the other aspects which we may not be able to control as individuals, but I think that's where I think we as a community should be able to come together and act on those larger things, larger opportunities where we can improve things. But anyway, so as a part of that, as a part of these bad experiences that we go through, we have a sphere of other groups who get directly impacted by this, right? So be it our families and other our friends, colleagues, and also citizens in the area that we live. And then there are micro worlds around those mini worlds. So it's a constant point to point, top downwards. It's a small universe within an universe kind of thing, wherein it's a cascading effect that you would have. So I think, so speaking about that, those experiences, system level experiences, which will also, which will actually have impact on us. So for instance, this is a screenshot from a train station in Bay Area, I believe, right? So this vending machine is to get your parking tickets. And this time when I took my flight, I took this train to the airport, and I had like just 3 hours of time on hand. And then this is the first time I've been, I kind of used because I usually get dropped by my wife or somebody else at the train station, and I just had to hop onto a train and then get to the airport. But this time we had to park the car, and this is the first time. And then this machine took us like 15 minutes to figure out what exactly needs to be done. And then this it clearly says that it shows a picture of the travel card and all those things, but then it only accepts cash in denomination of $1 and $5, and nobody in the US usually has $5 bills. Everybody has $20 bills. And to get some change, there is a change giving machine as well. And to get that change, you have to go back. You came in through those card reading machines inside the station, and then to get some change out, you need to go all the way back and then get some change, and then in the meantime, I had missed two trains. So that's one example. Then, and another example is this, right? So this is something that we keep seeing day in and day out, but then not to blame us, but I think it's something that is there in the system itself, because the standard speed on this road is 35, and then we are expected to drive at 25 not during school hours, but during when there are no children. There is a big difference between school hours and when there are no children. So if it says when children are not present, or when children are present, it's very ambiguous. So this kind of alert systems, which are more related to your cognitive thing, right? So there are some crossroads which actually highlight. So in those cases, it's very clear for you that even when you're in, I mean, when you're inside a car, so many things are going through your mind, right? So you don't actually notice this kind of small, tiny differences, because this 25 speed limit is transient. It's only for 15 minutes during a day when there is the school opens from 8:15 to 8:30, and that's it. I happened to pass through this street at normal speed at 35 on that day at 8:30. You don't expect any kids to be around, but to my bad luck, there were two kids and there was a cop. I was caught by a cop, and I was given a ticket right at the moment when I was coming back after dropping my wife. And I had to go to work on the day to attend a meeting, and then that screwed up my entire day. And that had an impact on all the work that I had to do, and that had an impact on my design, right? So it's all these things, and this is the extent it can get to. So there was a big confusing crossroad, and then somebody came and hit my car on another day. Right, so it's all these things. If you observe as designers, I think these kind of problems are there everywhere, be it in the US or beat India, and hence that's the reason why we have this platform wherein I think we should be responsible for our own things to start with. And if we can address these problems, I think it will have a much better impact, and we can do things that we want to do in the right way, right? So, and again, so speaking about impacting connected worlds, as the stress index grows, it will obviously impact other connected worlds that we have. So what it actually means is the more stress we take, the less happiness index that the customers would have. So so all in all, I think so a little tweak, and then if we can have a positive experience as designers, I think that will contribute to having a lot of a much larger happiness index for our customers, and also no concerns, and a much simpler life for the related worlds that we have, like in terms of our families and colleagues and friends and citizens. And yeah, so all it boils down to is design has been to do with form, function, experience, so on and so forth. And above all, I think it's all about self to start with. So it starts from self, and then if you are self-aware, then I think that will go a long way in creating the experiences that we always wanted to create, good experiences for our customers. Thank you.